Hello students, how are you? I hope you are fine you are in good health and having a good time. Sentences. You know, the English you learn up to your HSC classes, it is English for today. That means you are studying languages mainly. So, the language starts with words, sentences, etc. So, we are going to discuss languages. Sentence patterns. You know, you can classify sentences in two categories. First, according to the meaning, then according to the formation. If you all know, I know that according to the meaning, the sentences are in five kinds. That they are assertive sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence, sentence and exclamatory sentence. So you all know this, I know. And another classification is according to the formation. These are simple sentence, complex sentence, and compound sentences. And today we are going to discuss about sentences with formation. According to formation, that what is simple sentence, what is complex sentence, and compound sentence. First of all, it's going to be the simple sentence. You know that simple sentence composed of just one clause, that is independent clause. It is any simple sentence, general sentence, what we talk every day, like play cricket. These are simple sentences. Simple sentences just have one independent clause. So here I have written down the patterns, the simple sentences patterns that we have five patterns for simple sentences. That these are subject plus verb. What should be translated in the case that loves loudly. Here, she is subject, loves intransitive verb. This is pattern number one. Then we have another pattern, pattern number two, subject plus verb, that is intransitive verb plus object, that is putting place create. I hope you know that definition of a transitive sentence and transitive verb and intransitive verb. The transitive verb, the verb which takes an object, that is transitive verb, and the verb that doesn't take object, that is intransitive verb. In first pattern, you see that the verb loves, and this verb has no objects. Loudly is not object, it's an adverb. This just modifies the verb loves. How she loves? She loves loudly. And here in second pattern you see subject plus verb plus object. Here the verb is transitive because it has an object. What is that? Cricket. Putting place cricket. Where does putting play? Putting place cricket. So we have an answer for the verb. Play. What does he play? He plays cricket. So this is another pattern, pattern number two. And here we are discussing simple sentences. And simple sentences can be in these patterns: subject plus verb, intransitive verb, then subject plus verb, transitive verb, object, Then another pattern is subject plus verb plus subject complement. Here the verb is linking verb. You know the linking verb mainly what does it do? That it links, the verb links subject and the object. Object is called subject complement because it completes, the verb completes the subject. You see, he is happy. He is happy. It means that happy, who is happy? He. So, just we get extra information about the subjects. That is why the verb is called linking, because it links the subject and the complement. That's why it is linking verb and AP is subject complement, because it completes the subjects. Complement means which completes anything. So here AP completes the subject P. How is he? Is AP and this is he is subject, this is linking verb, and AP is subject complement. And subject complement may be adjective. Here it is adjective, it is adjective, it can be noun or pronoun also. Okay. Then next pattern is subject plus verb. Here verb is transitive, of course. Subject plus verb and direct object plus direct objects. Here object will be object will be two types. One is indirect object and then direct objects. First it will be indirect object, then direct objects. Okay. Like the example is she made him a cake. That is she is subject, made transitive verb. If indirect objects a cake, it is direct objects. What he made, what she made, what did she make, that she made a cake. If we ask the verb what, then we get the answer A. So that is A K is direct objects. And A K, she made for whom? For him. This is indirect objects. So this is the pattern is subject plus transitive verb plus indirect objects, objects and direct objects. So the next, the last one is subject plus verb. That will be transitive verb. Then objects plus objects complement. Here, object complements means that these objects will complete these objects. He made her happy. He made her happy. These objects make transitive verb are indirect objects and happy. Object complement. What? Why object complement? He made her happy. Who is happy here? She, her. She is happy, that's why this object complement. It completes her. It tells more about her. That's why it is object complement. So these are the patterns we use for simple sentences. So I hope you understood the discussion, and you will use simple sentence correctly next time, and it's now more clear for you. So this is all today. You discuss balance two types of sentences, complex and compound. Our next classes. Until then, so long.